Hello students, today we are going to study about the second part of Raoult's law, that is ideal and non-ideal solutions. So basically, what are ideal and non-ideal solutions? Okay, on the basis of Raoult's law, the liquid-liquid solutions, they have been classified into two types. One is ideal solution and one is non-ideal solution. So let us see what are these two types of solutions. What are ideal solutions? See the definition here. The solutions which obey Raoult's law over the entire range of concentration, temperature and pressure are known as ideal solutions. So these are the solutions which obey Raoult's law. And what was Raoult's law? It was PA is equal to PA naught chi A for a component A and PB is equal to PB naught chi B for a component B. So P total would be PA naught chi A plus PB naught chi B. So these were the mathematical relations in Raoult's law. So ideal solutions would be those solutions which will obey all the mathematical relations that were given under Raoult's law. Okay, besides those mathematical relations, the ideal solutions have got two very important properties. First is delta H mixing is equal to 0 and second is delta V mixing is equal to 0. Now what does this mean? Delta H mixing is equal to 0 means when the components are forming the solution, the process of mixing is neither exothermic and nor it is endothermic if the components on mixing form an ideal solution. That means there will be no release of heat also and there will be no absorption of heat also during mixing. Second is delta V mixing is equal to 0. What does this mean? This means that the total volume, that is the sum of the volumes of the two components, will be exactly same after mixing. That means if I say, suppose we take 10 ml of a component A and we mix it with 10 ml of another component B, then after mixing, the volume of the solution will be exactly equal to the sum of the volumes of A and B, that is 10 plus 10, 20 ml. So the volume after mixing will be exactly 20 ml, nor less than that, nor higher than that. Okay. At molecular level, we can explain ideal solutions with the help of the interactions between the molecules. See, there is this diagram here where you can see that the component A in pure state, suppose if I say this is the component A and it is having interactions between its molecules and is represented as AA. This is the component B and the interactions between the molecules of B are represented as BB. Now, after mixing A with B, it forms a solution here where we have molecules of both A as well as molecules of B. So, the interaction that is existing inside the solution is represented as AB. So, the pure component interactions are AA and BB and the solution interaction are AB. Now, see what happens in case of ideal solution. In case of ideal solution, we say that the interactions of the pure component, that is AA and BB, is exactly equal to the interactions between the molecules in solution, that is AB. That is AA is equal to BB is equal to AB. So if the intermolecular forces that exist in the pure component and in the mixture is same, then we say that the solution that is formed is an ideal solution. However, like we know that an ideal gas is not possible, similarly, an ideal solution is also very rare. If at all an ideal solution has to form, there are certain examples given here. If you see N-hexane, N-heptane, benzene, toluene, bromoethane, chloroethane, these are some mixtures that form ideal solution. Please note one thing here, that the pairs of components that form an ideal solution, generally they have got similar structure. As you can see here, N-hexane, N-heptane has got similar structure. Similarly, bromoethane, chloroethane has got similar structure. So these pairs of components that form ideal solution, they generally have got similar structures. Okay, so now what will be non-ideal solutions then? Non-ideal solutions will be the ones which do not obey Raoult's law. If they do not obey Raoult's law, that means that for a particular component A, PA will not be equal to PA naught chi A, right? Because in Raoult's law, it was stated that for a component, it has to be always PA is equal to PA naught chi A. But now, if the solution is not following Raoult's law, then in that case, the components will not be following the mathematical equation also. That is PA or PI in general for any component, if I say for any component I, PI will not be equal to PI naught chi I if the solution form is a non-ideal solution. Now what will happen? Two cases may happen. Either the value of PI will be less than the value of PI naught chi I, or the value of PI will be greater than the value of PI naught chi I. So this is the graphical representation. If you remember, in case of Raoult's law, when we had drawn the graph was a linear line. The vapor pressure and the mole fraction was varying linearly with each other. So in these two diagrams, you can see the dotted lines, the dotted green lines, they represent ideal solution. But the solid blue lines, they represent the graph of the solutions which are non-ideal. Now, two cases can happen. In the first case, the graph of the non-ideal solution, that is representing the vapor pressure of the solutions, they lie above the line of the ideal solution. And in this case, the graph of the non-ideal solution lie below the line of the ideal solution. So these are the two cases of deviation from Raoult's law. In the first case, we say that there is positive deviation from Raoult's law in which the vapor pressure has increased than the expected vapor pressure from Raoult's law. And here it is known as negative deviation in which the vapor pressure has decreased than expected from Raoult's law. In terms of mathematical relation, we can say that here what is happening, the vapor pressure has increased. That means here PI will be greater than PI naught chi I, and in this case PI will be lesser than PI naught chi I. Okay. At molecular level, again, if we see, if you remember, in case of ideal solutions, what was happening? The interactions in solution were same as the interactions in the pure components. That was ideal solution. But when it is not showing, when it is not forming ideal solution, in that case, the interactions will be either lesser or greater than the interactions in pure components. See here. If the interactions are weaker, if the interactions between A and B are weaker than the original interactions in the pure components, then it would result in positive deviation. And if the interactions are stronger, it would result in negative deviation. Okay, so let us understand this in a more better. See here, in case of positive deviation, the interactions between the pure components is higher than the interaction in solution. So what is happening? The components that had very strong interaction in the pure form, they are going to mix, and after mixing, the interactions are going to decrease. Now tell me, if the interactions decrease between the molecules, will the vapor pressure increase or decrease? You have to recall here that vapor pressure depends on molecular forces and temperature. With molecular forces, vapor pressure has got an inverse relation. If the molecular forces are higher, vapor pressure will be lower. Why? Because if the molecular forces are higher, then less amount of less amount of molecules would be going into the vapor state. And if less vapors are formed, then definitely the vapor pressure exerted would also be less. So that means if the interactions are decreasing, the vapor pressure is also decreasing. Sorry, if the interactions are decreasing, the vapor pressure is increasing. And if the interactions are increasing, then the vapor pressure is decreasing, right? So if the interactions are decreasing, the vapor pressure is increasing, means it is showing positive deviation. And here the opposite is happening. The interactions are increasing, because of which the vapor pressure is going to decrease and the solution will be showing negative deviation. Okay. The second point of difference between the two is that here the process of mixing is an endothermic process and here the process of mixing is an exothermic process. Now you see, this can also be explained with the help of interaction. Since I already told you that in case of positive deviation, the interactions in the pure form was very, very strong. Now, if you have to mix the two components and after mixing, since the interactions would become less, it would be difficult for us to break the bonds that were already so strong and form a mixture. If at all we want to form a mixture, we have to break the strong bonds, the strong interactions that were already present in the pure components. And in that case, we would have to supply heat. And whenever we supply heat, the process becomes endothermic, right? Okay, here what is happening? Here after mixing, the interactions are becoming stronger. That means more strong bonds are being formed. So when more strong bonds are being formed, then instead of our supplying heat, what will happen during mixing? There will be release of heat and hence the process would be exothermic. Okay, so next, talking about the volume. Here the volume of mixing, delta V, is greater than zero, and here the volume after mixing would be less than zero. Here also, this also can be explained with the help of molecular interaction. See here, what is happening? That after mixing, the forces that were very strong initially now has become weak. Now if the forces become weak, that means that after mixing, the solution is going to undergo a slight amount of expansion. And if there is slight amount of expansion, then in that case the volume is going to increase and hence the delta V mixing will be not exactly equal to the sum of the initial volumes. Instead, it would be higher. And here what is happening? Since after mixing the forces have become very strong, that is why the molecules will come closer to each other and the total volume is going to become more compact. And here what will happen? The sum of the initial volumes and the volume that you get after mixing will not be same. In fact, the final volume is going to be slightly less than the sum of the individual volumes. That is, delta V mixing will now be less than zero. This I already told you that in case of positive deviation, Pi or P1 will be greater than the expected pressure from Raoult's law, and here it will be lesser than the expected pressure from Raoult's law. Ethanol plus water, these are the pairs that will be showing positive deviation from Raoult's law, and here chloroform and acetone, this pair will be showing negative deviation from Raoult's law. You can easily see here, see ethanol, you know, it has got very strong hydrogen bonding within its molecules, and water has also got very strong hydrogen bonding within its molecules. When you have to mix ethanol with water now, you have to break the hydrogen bonds that are already existing between the molecules, and that is why the process will result in a positive deviation. Since after mixing, the hydrogen bonds between the two is not going to be as strong as the initial hydrogen bonds. Similarly, here also acetone molecule we are taking, chloroform we are taking, when we mix them, there occurs strong hydrogen bonding between the two, and that is why, because of increased interaction, they are going to show negative deviation. Okay, so here is the summary of what we have done now. See, ideal solution, non-ideal solution. Ideal solution, it obeys Raoult's law. Under non-ideal solution, we have got positive as well as negative. Both does not obey Raoult's law. You can see for yourself. These are the things that we had already discussed. Just see, they have given in terms of pressure, in terms of delta H mixing, delta V mixing. This is with respect to the interactions that is existing between the three. And these are the graphical representations. Okay, I hope it is clear to all of you. Okay, coming to the last part of Raoult's law, that is azeotropes. Now, what are azeotropes? Azeotropes are binary mixtures that have got the same composition in liquid and the vapor phase, and they boil at a constant temperature. Okay, so this is the definition, and it says that the mixtures which has got the same composition and boil at a constant temperature are known as azeotropes. In other words, we can say constant boiling mixtures are known as azeotropes. Okay, and these azeotropes, the components of an azeotropic mixture cannot be separated by fractional distillation, and that is because the components of an azeotropic mixture, they boil at a constant temperature. And if anything boils at a constant, if a mixture boils at a constant temperature, it is not possible to separate it by fractional distillation. Now, what is meant by same composition? See here, before that, you just see here, there are two types of azeotropes. First is minimum boiling azeotrope, and second is maximum boiling azeotrope. In minimum boiling azeotrope, the example is ethanol plus water, in which ethanol is present in approximately 95% by volume and water is 5%. So here it is a fixed ratio, 95 is to 5. And this ratio is very important for this mixture to form an azeotrope. This particular mixture of ethanol and water will be forming an azeotrope only when the components ethanol and water are present in the ratio of 95 is to 5, not otherwise. Right. Similarly, maximum boiling azeotrope example is nitric acid plus water, where nitric acid is present in 68% by mass and water is present in the ratio in 32% by mass. So the ratio here is also fixed. So until and unless the ratios of the two components of the azeotropic mixture is fixed, we will not be able to get an azeotrope. If you change the concentrations, if you change the ratio of the mixture, then it will no longer remain an azeotrope. Hence, it is very important that if you are asked to give examples of azeotrope, you are not only going to write the mixture, you also have to mention the exact percentage or the exact ratio at which that particular mixture can form an azeotrope. Okay, another important thing that you need to note here. See here, minimum boiling azeotrope is formed by ethanol plus water. And if you remember, ethanol plus water was giving positive deviation from Raoult's law. Similarly, maximum boiling azeotrope is formed by nitric acid plus water. And this mixture gives a negative deviation from Raoult's law. So, minimum boiling azeotrope is formed by those mixtures which show positive deviation. And maximum boiling azeotrope is formed by those solutions which show negative deviation from Raoult's law. Fine. Next important thing, another thing here is important. Just remember, suppose if I say that a particular mixture is forming a minimum boiling azeotrope, then in that case, the boiling point of the azeotrope would be less than either of the components. Did you understand what I am saying? See here, suppose if I say ethanol, for example, it has got a boiling point of around 78 degrees Celsius, and water we know has a boiling point of 100 degrees Celsius. Now, when this particular mixture forms an azeotrope, at that time, the azeotrope will be having a boiling point that is less than 78 degrees Celsius because it is forming minimum boiling azeotrope. Got it? Similarly, here also, nitric acid also has got a boiling point of around 85 degrees Celsius, and water has got a boiling point of around 100 degrees Celsius. So in this case, the azeotrope will be having a boiling point which is higher than 100 degree Celsius, since it is forming a maximum boiling azeotrope. Clear? So in minimum boiling azeotrope, the boiling point is lesser than the components, and in maximum boiling azeotrope, the boiling point will be higher than the components. I hope it is clear to all of you. Thank you.